I would gladly lend my hand to sink the whole island of Great Britain in the ocean. When will we escape this dreadful city, Doctor?
Philadelphia is not to your liking, sir.
Well, I'd rather be in my own country.
I have read your summary view of the rights of British America. I have a great opinion of the elegance of your pen.
This is well said, sir. Very, very well said.
I will defend every word of it.
Well, that's what I believe. I want to build a new portico.
Is it not magnificent, John?
This is a marvelous invention, Mr. Jefferson.
I have not heard you say three words together in the last chorus.
I have no gift for oratory.
For all of Mr. Jefferson's sadness, there is a great charm about him.
France is in the throes of a violent birth. We should rejoice.
There are those who say that Mr. Jefferson is more Frenchman than American.
Thomas thinks that in his retirement, he will get the reputation of a humble man without ambition or vanity. He may even have deceived himself into that belief, but the world will find that he is as ambitious as any man.
I cannot imagine losing a child and your wife in 1 year.
Perhaps the art of life is the art of avoiding pain. I will not enter office but in perfect freedom to follow the dictates of my own judgment.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, and that all men are created equal.